Hey guys, how's it going? I hope everybody's doing well out there. Well, these are finally done, my modded amp simulation patches for the Line 6 Helix and the HX Stomp. They're going to be released simultaneously right now. They're on my website. You can go grab them there. Now, the way this works is you click on the link, it'll take you to PayPal, and then after your transaction, they will automatically download to your computer, and then you can load them up into your units. If for some reason you don't get the download link, just shoot me an email. I'm always available. I'll send them to you right away. Now, these are modded amp simulation patches. What is that? Well, I collected 10 of the most sought after modded amps that exist today, okay? These technicians went into these amps and they modded them, and they all have this high-end, high mid-range characteristic to the tone. You can really hear it in your pick attack. I don't know if you've been keeping up with all my videos, but they have this certain tone characteristics. It's hard to explain, but I was able to capture that with an impulse response. Now, to load these, the patches can go in any location you like. The impulse responses have to be in certain locations, and they're numbered. Each one of these impulse responses has a number. So their name in the file name is GD dash and then a number. All you got to do is load that impulse response into the number. So on the in the impulse response column in the HX Edit software. For the Helix, they start from 45 and you run through number 54, that's 10. And then on the HX Stomp, they start at number 112 and run through number 121. Okay, so you just you highlight the entire lot of them, and you just drag them and drop them on that number, and they will each load one by one by one. And the IR location is programmed into the patch. So the patches will know where to find the IRs, no matter where you put the patches. You can put one in user bank one, one in user bank two. I wouldn't suggest you do that, but if you wanted to do that, the patch will find the IR if they're loaded in the correct position. Now, for those of you that have IRs that are already in those spots, you can move them to any location you want. You just have to go into the patch and tell the IR where you loaded that IR, and then you resave the patch. But if you don't have to do that, you just load my IRs in the numbers. Now, I've been doing these videos for the last few weeks. I'm gonna run through a short sample of each one of these, okay? Here's the list of amps you have. It's 10 of them. It's a pretty impressive list of amps. Without these impulse responses, there's no way you could get this tone. You can use EQs till you're blue in the face. It will not work. The impulse response is everything to this tone. Now, without the impulse response, they sound pretty darn good by themselves. You're gonna notice that I used, on a majority of them, I used a core amp, the same core amp. I call it a core amp because I try to get the tone as best as I can by ear without the impulse response. And then I use that to make the impulse response and sample the real deal amp. And when you apply that impulse response to the patch that already sounds kind of close to it, when that impulse response is on, boom, that's it, that's the tone. So it's very important to load those impulse responses in the correct positions. Now, I'm going to go through a short sample of all 10 of these right now, and they are available now on my website. I hope they sound as good on your end as they do on mine. They just absolutely killer. Don't let that high-end mid-range scare you on these patches, okay? That is what you need to slice through a mix. These slice through a mix like butter, okay? If it's too high-end for you, just dial back the high cut a little bit in the impulse response. And also, if it's too woofy on the low end for you, dial up that low end in the impulse response. Dial up the low cut. I wouldn't go past 80 or 90 hertz though, because beyond that, you're starting to mess with the tone of the impulse response too much. So, but here's the short sample. And again, they are available. Thank you so much for your continued support. I really do appreciate each and every one of you guys. And until I see you again, I've got some really cool things coming up, by the way. Until I see you again, as always, rock on.
We'll be right back.